Since 1868, the Tabasco brand of red pepper sauce and other products have come from Avery Island in southern Louisiana. Despite its name, Avery Island is not an island. But if you drive about 150 miles west from New Orleans, you will intersect with this location of Tabasco's home, a salt dome above the surrounding marsh landscape. Tabasco has an interesting story of coastal adaptation, one where they have learned to face the challenges of past human activities and natural disasters. By taking action and creating partnerships in the present to become stewards of the surrounding natural resources, Tabasco is ensuring a sustainable future for the environment and its pepper sauce. I decided to use the quilting pattern known as windowpane block or attic window to share Tabasco's story. A fabric with a brick pattern was selected for the border and the back to represent the brick of the Tabasco factory buildings. The green and purple fabric in the six window panes paid tribute to two of the official Mardi Gras colors. Starting with the top left window pane, one sees the Tabasco logo. It is a distressed logo with the white screen print cracked and broken in several places, representing the stress the factory and warehouse is under in its current location because of the environment. Looking through the top center window, one sees a landscape, a bayou and marsh, and a cross-section of the hill where the Tabasco factory sits on top. At 163 feet above sea level, the factory is located on a salt dome. The fabric is salt crystals and is one of the highest points along the Gulf Coast. The top right window pane shows the equipment used for prior dredging of the wetlands to build canals to lay oil and gas pipelines. These canals allowed for saltwater intrusion, which killed off freshwater vegetation, which then led the canals to increase in size because of the eroding banks. The bottom left window pane shows the wooden casks that contain the Tabasco mash, peppers that have been ground into a salt mash and stored for 3 years. In September 2005, Hurricane Rita sent a surge of water that came inches from the production factory, but the warehouse and its 60,000 barrels of mash went under 3 feet of water. The bottom center window pane shows one of the immediate protection efforts undertaken by the Tabasco factory, the construction of a 20-foot-high earthen levee with a pump system around the production area. There was also extensive planting of hardy cord grasses to restore the damaged marsh. The final window pane in the bottom right is a snapshot of the outcomes of these restoration efforts. The increasing numbers of snowy egrets, alligators, fish, and black bears, to name a few. Several projects ranging from marsh creation to erosion control are taking place, thanks to Tabasco, private property owners, the National Audubon Society, the Rainy Conservation Alliance, and America's Wetland Foundation. More marsh benefits everyone, especially when the next storm comes through. Not if the next storm arrives, but when. I was fortunate to have the opportunity to visit and tour the Tabasco factory, bringing my completed quilt along for the journey. It is hard to put into words and even into a quilt what a special location this is. I hope my images have helped share the historical context and shown the natural beauty of the landscape and communicated this story of coastal optimism. A story of a company that has been in a family for several generations and located in the same location for more than 150 years, working with the environment and the community to minimize the loss of land and restore wetlands and wildlife.